Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Albin Planinc and Miguel Najdorf. This absolutely amazing chess game was played in the Netherlands in 1973. Planinc had white pieces and he started with e4. Najdorf played c5, the Sicilian defense, knight to f3, d6, d4, c takes on d4, knight takes on d4, knight to f6, knight to c3, black to move. What would Najdorf do? Najdorf of course played a6, his own variation, the Najdorf variation. Bishop to g5, e6, f4. This is a popular main line. Knight from b to d7, queen to f3. Pushing the pawn doesn't work, does it? If e5, then d takes on e5, and after pawn takes pawn, knight takes on e5. Back to our game. Queen to f3, intending to castle queenside. Bishop to e7 on pinning, and Planinc castled queenside as planned. Queen to c7, white to move. g4 and bishop to d3 are the most played moves. Planinc played bishop to d3. h6, asking a question. Should bishop go to h4? Take the knight, what would you do? Planinc played queen to h3, pinning the pawn. Knight to c5, rook from h to e1, and white army is fully mobilized. White has a better development. Rook to g8, threatening to capture the bishop. Let's take it back. How about e5? If e5, then knight to f5. And again, white stands better. Back to our game. Rook to g8 was played. White move. Should white play bishop to h4 or something else? What would you do? Instead of moving the bishop, Planinc played e5, intending to open the files. D takes on e5, f takes on e5, h takes on g5, pawn takes knight, bishop takes pawn, and black is now a pawn up. White to move. What would you do? Planinc played knight to d5, attacking the queen. The pawn is pinned. Queen to d8, the black queen went home. But now bishop to h7, attacking the rook. The rook went home too. But this looks good for black. At least on the surface. The bishop is pinned. White to move. How would you continue now? Planinc played knight to f5. The black pawn on e6 must have been frustrated with the pin. He can only smell horses, but can't touch them. g4, attacking the queen. Queen to g3. Black to move. King to f8 was played. If rook takes bishop, what happens then? Then knight to c7 check, and white wins after king to f8. Rook takes queen. Back to our game. That is why Najdorf played king to f8. White to move. Believe it or not, white played a move and black resigned, and the move is knight takes bishop. Najdorf resigned. If g takes on f6, then what happens then? Then rook takes queen. Queen takes knight must be a better move. If queen takes knight, then queen to d6 check. After king to e8, we have a deflection tactic. Knight takes on g7, check. Deflecting the black queen from defending the d8 square. After queen takes knight, queen to d8, check. Mate. Amazing, isn't it? No wonder they say that chess is art. What do you think of this game?